Hi there, so I promised for some time to do a detailed breakdown of play one of Myers Dagger for people who've done workshops and stuff like that with us. Few simple things that I want you to bear in mind as you go through. Most of them are to do with keeping with your original intention until something else interrupts that and makes you do something else. So quite often as we're going through this, don't move for a second, it's very, very easy to get in the habit of going, I do this because I know that I'm going to do this, okay? So I go for a high thrust rather than actually going for a low thrust first, and then when it's deviated, coming into a high thrust. We must make sure that our first intention is actually to do the technique. When we deliver that first technique, we must make sure that we are thinking of our own safety as much as we can, given the circumstance. So by that I mean that rather than just going here, I'm rushing in, if you go up into a high guard for us. If I just do this, obviously my partner can just retreat, slip back and just hack at us or try and control us and start hacking. So we want to be aware of our distance, and we're using quite a long distance initially to get to this. So our distance really is going to be enough to get to this point, one. Okay? You'll notice as I'm going through this as well, I am committing my weight to the technique. As we go through the drill, it's very, very common for you to start slipping back early to start putting in the escape that comes in at the last part of this technique, which you'll see as we go through. And it's very easy to start getting into this habit of going, oh, you know what, I'm going to start slipping back before I've actually delivered my first technique. Again, we need to stay in the mindset of delivering each technique, and we'll give you a breakdown of each of these as this occurs. So the first action, if you go into the high guard for us, is very, very simple. We're just simply from this position just stepping in the saddle. Okay, and it's very, very nice, simple one. I'm not retreating as I'm doing this, I'm still trying to come here, okay? And I'm trying to use quite a long distance in doing so, but I am committing forwards into this at the back, okay? So if Amos does this here, if you just stand for me here, okay? Make sure you are going to hit, okay? The next action is that we simply break down through our central line here, and we take the dagger to the side, and one of the most common things you see when you do this is that if Amos actually does stab me, people do this, and as you can see, it won't actually clear the line. And the reason we do this and don't clear the line is because usually people are thinking of doing the secondary technique here. They're thinking of coming up to do the attack to the face, okay? So, or underneath the arm, rather, okay? So we must make sure that we clear first for our own safety, then we return to do the technique. So here, as he stabs in, one, and then we clear and we stab into the armpit. Okay, so nice, gentle, and keep it very, very lively, very gentle as we're doing. And we're just going to swap this backwards and forwards as we go. Okay, so here, one, two. Now, you see here, he's giving a very, very vigorous, wide lateral movement. And this is too much. It must be enough to clear, but it must be enough to clear and then come back straight into the technique. So here, one, two. Here, one, two. You'll notice each time I'm going through this that I'm giving myself enough distance on the slip just to allow myself to stay safe. So if you notice, Danis is staying very, very stock still when he's doing his technique. As Danis is coming in for the stab here, I'm slipping slightly back, usually after the clearance. One. Okay? So I'm giving myself a little bit more room to work as we go. Okay? Now again, we're not going to slip back far enough that our return technique becomes irrelevant. For instance, here if he stabs like so, one, I'm not going to slip back here and then not be able to reach. I still want to be in distance to hit, but then I'm giving myself a little bit extra distance to work against his blow coming back towards me. Okay? So here, one, two, here, one, two. Okay, nice and relaxed. Still keeping that intention of going through the blow. Okay. Then we go on to the second part of the technique. Now the second part of the technique really needs to be done within the tempo of the parrying down and lateral action. So we've got a natural and off line here. Okay. So here, as I'm going in here, I'm not waiting for this to be pulled to the side and then coming like so sideways. What I'm doing is just slipping the action as it comes in. So one, two, okay? So Fainer starts coming through. As this action's here, he's going immediately that it's happening. This means that my hand should still be going sideways as he changes direction, rather than being in its return forwards as we come forwards, okay? So we need to be moving again as this hand is retreating from the center, dropping down through the center and coming here. this is the most valuable point for us to attack back into the neck. Okay? So again, if I start going for Danis, I go here, and then as soon as he's there, it's a nice little light turn and come back around into the throat. You notice all of these being delivered with courtesy. At no point am I trying to be jumpy, trying to stay calm so that I can keep my partner safe as we go through the drill. Would you like to go through? Okay? And you see that if we're doing this slightly too late, as we both are here, what's happening is that because we're waiting for the impact here, by the time we've come to here, you're getting a double shot. Okay? And this is why you want to roll through. So if you see the difference between this, again, if you make sure that he is hooking and coming back in, you should notice a slight difference in the timing of the delivery. Okay? Okay, and here, one, two. Okay? So if you see there, the arm should be on top at the end, which makes it a little bit more difficult for him to successfully come through underneath. Good. Excellent. Don't jerk.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay, so always maintaining that safety. Good. Okay? Always making sure that action is nice and rolling through. Okay, so you see, if you get the timing right, we should just be delivering the shot and then just rolling simply around with kind of a half circular movement as we go, rather than impacting on the blade and then trying to come here. Okay, so again, it goes one, slips, good, excellent, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, good. Okay, from there, we now have our third action here, okay? So at this point here, if you deliver the thrust through underneath, please, here, he comes like so. Now it's important at this point, I'm still going for this action, and I'm still going for this action as a follow-up. A clear, and then a stab underneath the armpit, okay? Now what's the resulting action comes from this is that rather than being like so, a hook and then a lift, which tends to lift the blow up into your eyes, this is going to be one, my intention is going to be going to go underneath, but then I'm going to pull back slightly as I go through here. So I'm going to end up coming with a slightly forward motion. It's very, very difficult to see this because what we are doing is we're reacting as we notice his attack change. We're not really waiting for it. But my intention must be to hook, return, and then I'll return fairly instinctively, I hope. Okay? So here, he comes in, one, two. Okay? Again, keep it nice and calm. We go in, one, two. In comes, one, two. Okay, so you see that the action of actually deciding I want to pump this into the side underneath the armpit here and the return back into this action is actually fairly instinctive and natural because you don't want to get stabbed. So from this point here, the hook, the return, we change our mind. We hook on the wrist or on the dagger. We close in with our left, and you can't see it here because the angle, I'm basically jamming my foot behind his foot and then crushing into his knee slightly as I deliver this stab here, okay? So if you roll through this a few times, come this way ever so slightly for me, please, here, one, two. See, that was too late for my action. That was my fault, I left the action too late. So one, two, good. Again, part of the problem there was that he went down, up, rather than coming one, forwards, then back, okay? This initiation of the attack underneath the armpit is what will make this action coming backwards actually work as we go through. Okay? So if I may, here, one, two, three. Close, stop. Good. Good. Very, very nice. Good. Excellent. Then the last part of the exercise is very, very simple. Is again, I don't want to get hit. Now, the action that you couldn't see very well, unfortunately, where the foot's locked behind here, what we have is we have, face towards me, please. Face towards me, as normal, foot forwards, here, okay? I'm gonna step behind his leg here and lock it up, okay? Now, if he's stepping behind my leg, it's useless to me if I've allowed him actually to put the lock into the leg. So what I'm doing is I'm slipping as soon as I see his hand coming through. I'm not bothering to keep my right leg forwards, I'm slipping the right leg back immediately against the pick. And you'll notice that not only do I step backwards, which would basically mean that the attack is going to still be coming onto my front line here, is as I pull my right foot back here, I'm going to spin myself offline here, okay? And this is fairly natural. You have to be careful about not roaming yourself on the dagger, okay? So you need to be aware of that dagger as it comes down and through, okay? So, if I may, here, one, two. Again, notice the poor timing here. I waited for him to react. He did the action. Donk, then I went around, and this gives you a very, very flawed action. We need to move as we see the dagger descending. So here, again, hand on hip, please, and right above the center of your head, okay? So here, one, two, okay? Now you see when the action comes down then up, it pulls the dagger into your eyes. So I need to watch out to keep you safe. He needs to watch out that he's still putting this action here. One, two, good, much better. Here. And here, he's gonna step his foot out. Before my foot locks, palm it and twist as I go. Here, making sure, one, two. Again, too late on the thrust. One, two, good. As soon as we see it, okay? Now here, I'm also, as he's doing this action here, rather than trying to confront it into it, I'm pulling it this way and going with his intention to stab into this angle and then encouraging it on as we go through this. And then stabbing furiously, really, as much as possible, okay? So, here, one, what's going underneath, check, foot, he spins. Good, okay? One, two. One, two. Okay? So that's very, very simple. In all cases, as we go through this drill, I am trying, and Danis is trying, to make sure that we're abiding by those principles. We're making sure we initiate the attack. We still maintain our intention to put that in unless anything happens to deviate it. Once that deviation becomes necessary, we react out of that necessity to counteract the action. Okay? So you need to make sure, one, that you're going in with intention to attack. Secondly, that you're not so mindlessly involved in that attack that you can't change. So it's intention, change. Then really it's moving early, but slower. So this is something I talk about quite a lot when we're training, is making sure that rather than doing something, for example, like so, bomb, waiting, now it's too late, now I need to go sudden, is we react earlier, slower. Earlier, slower, okay? And that means that, first of all, we're doing something which fundamentally is very, very instinctive. It's very, very rare, for example, if someone's doing any action, okay? He does an action and whatever it is, I go, I'll wait here, and then I'll go at the end, which is what you see in training drills. It's really fucking annoying because you're there going, what are you doing? Why are you not trying? He puts a knife up. I don't want to die, okay? So we do something that involves us as much as possible, reacting early. And that doesn't have to be a full tilt fucking furious thing because we're training. But what it must be is it must be immediate, okay? We must, as soon as we can reach the threat, deal with the threat. And even if that means that the other person can then see what we're doing, which is fundamentally what fencing is, we can then go through and we can deal with that in that manner. Okay? I hope this has helped. Take care. Bye-bye.